Hello students, today we are going to discuss previous IIT JEE questions, heat transfer part 2, based on subtopics, Stefan's law, Newton's law of cooling, rate of heat flow, thermal current, energy flux, effective thermal conductivity. Let us start our first question, which is given in JEE Main 2019, 12th January morning online, which is based on effective thermal conductivity. So here, a cylinder of radius r surrounded by a cylindrical shell. Cylinder is there, is surrounded by cylindrical shell. Inner radius is r and outer radius is 2r. Let us see how visualize this situation. Here I am taking one cylinder. The outer cylinder, let me draw inner cylinder. Inner cylinder. Here radius r and 2r. If I take radius for inner one is given as r and outer one is given as 2r from the setup. R and 2r, inner and outer cylinders. Okay, now let us the thermal conductivity of material of inner one is k1. Thermal conductivity of inner one is k1 and outer one is k2. Then outer cylinder k2. Assume no loss of heat. Calculate effective thermal conductivity of the system for heat flowing along the length of the cylinder. Right, now heat is flowing here, so heat flow through this. This is the flow of heat. The flow of heat. Heat flows. We take this nothing but temperature T1. The other side is temperature T2. So T1 and T2 are the temperatures. Next, let us take the area of inner cylinder. Nothing but A1. This is A1. Next, outer, if you take, so annular shaped one. See, like this, outer cylinder. So, which is nothing but A2. So, A1 and A2 are the area of cross section. I hope this diagram is clear. Now, we can proceed. Here, in parallel combination, if you see these two cylinders are considered to be in parallel. So, parallel combination. Parallel. Combination. Parallel combination. Equivalent thermal conductivity. Equivalent. Thermal conductivity is given by A1, K1, A1 plus K2, A2 divided by A1 plus A2 for different areas and different thermal conductivities. If both thermal conductivity, both areas are equal, A1 equal to A2 equal to A, then we can get K effective equal to K1 plus K2. This is nothing but parallel combination. Areas are different. Now let us proceed. Here, if I take K A1, area of first cylinder, inner cylinder, pi r square, and area of second cylinder. Second cylinder means outer cylinder. Outer cylinder, you can see this is nothing but annular parts. Right? So, this area we require, only this area. So, how to calculate that one? That can be calculated as pi into 2r square minus pi into r square. Then we can get this particular shaded area, whatever I shaded. Okay, the shaded area we can obtain. Fine. Now we got A1 and A2. Simply substituting these values, here we can write A2 equal to 4 pi r square minus pi r square, or area A2 equal to 3 pi r square. Now simply substituting, K effective equal to K1 into pi r square plus K2 into 3 pi r square divided by 4 pi r square. Now K effective equal to pi. If you remove pi and r square, I can write pi r square is taken outside. Then I can write K1 plus K2 3K2 divided by 4 pi r square. So these two will get cancelled. Then our final K effective equal to K1 plus 3K2 divided by 4. So this is the result what we are getting. That's K1 plus 3K2 divided by 4. So which matches with the option D. So D is the correct answer. Just to check it out once here. Here T1 is greater than T2. We have two cylinders, that is inner and outer cylinders, or inner cylinder of radius R and outer cylinder is nothing but cylindrical shell of inner is R and outer is nothing but 2R cylinder, right? So it is a parallel combination. So whenever we get parallel combination, the effective thermal conductivity, so this already in the classroom coaching, this will be derived. So A1 equal to A2 is equal to A, K effective, both are equal, then K effective. Then calculations of areas, so A1 equal to pi r square, A2 equal to 3 pi r square, here A2 minus A1. So hope this is clear, then we'll move to the next question. Next we'll move to JE Main 2019, 10th January morning online. Here according to the question, heat source which is at a temperature of 10 to the power of 3 Kelvin. So let me take like a heat source. This is a heat source whose temperature is 10 to the power of 3 Kelvin is connected to another heat reservoir at temperature 100 Kelvin. Let us take it is connected to another heat reservoir at a temperature of 10 to the power of 2 Kelvin by a copper slab of 1 meter thickness. That means it is connected by a copper slab. Let us take it as this a copper slab of 1 meter thickness. Nothing but 1 meter. Then the coefficient of thermal conductivity of copper is given. Coefficient of thermal conductivity of a copper, K equal to 0.1 per verse meter inverse. The energy flux to the steady state. What is the energy flux to the steady state? This is based on what? Energy flux. We know that energy flux in a thermal conduction. In thermal conduction, energy flux is nothing but energy flux is equal to energy flow. Flow per second meter square. So that is energy flow per unit area is nothing but energy flux we will call. Now in steady state, we know that thermal conduction will use dq by dt equals to k into a t1 minus t2 by x. Right? Now if I want energy flux from this equation, then I can write right here energy flux. Energy flux equals to 1 by A into dq by dt, energy per unit area. So this is clear. Energy per unit area equal to now k into delta t, which I can write t1 minus t2 by x equals to. Here you can see the thermal conductivity value is given. Value of thermal conductivity 0.1. So I'll write 0.1 into t1. T1 is 10 power 3, it is 1000 minus T2 value is 10 to the power of 2, it is 100 minus X. X value is given, thickness of the slab is 1 meter. Now energy flux equal to 0.1 into 900, which is nothing but 90 watt per meter square. So we'll be getting energy flux. Meter square, which matches with the option A. Fine. Here it is matching with the option. Fine. A. Hope this is clear. Energy flux, how we calculate it. Hope it's nothing but energy flux. For energy flux means energy per unit area. So formula for energy flux is 1 by A into dq by dt. So already in steady state, we know that dq by dt equals to k into A into T1 minus T2 divided by X. Here, hot reservoir, hot source and hot reservoir, heat source and heater reservoir, this is nothing but copper. Hope this is clear. Tell this one. Next, we'll move to JEE Main 2019, 9th January morning online, which is based on thermal currents. So you can see this problem. The temperature difference, 120 degrees, is maintained between the two ends of a uniform rod AB. So you can see in the diagram, A, this is nothing but junction A, here it is B, temperature difference of a length 2L, total length of it is 2L, that means the remaining length is L by 2. Now you can see the total length of the rods, L by 2 plus L by 2, this is nothing but 2L given. So this is about the first rod. Now second rod, another rod PQ of same cross-sectional as AB, across a cross section is AB and length is 3L by 2. Here length of it is 3L by 2 is connected across AB as shown in the figure. So here you can see this is nothing but P and Q. So one rod of L 3L by 2 is bent as shown in the figure. In steady state, the temperature difference between P and Q. Steady state, the temperature difference between P and Q close to. Now to solve this type of question, let us see. First, let's take in terms of thermal resistance. Here it is A. Resistance till this one is P. Because we know that thermal resistance, already we calculated in the last session, L by K into A. This is nothing but thermal resistance. Thermal resistance is equal to L by K into A. So it is directly proportional to length. Thermal resistance directly proportional to length. So I can write here thermal resistance for this resistor is R by 2. Next, here P to Q, this length is L. So I can write here R. Again, this length can be written as, this resistor can be written as 3R by 2. 3R divided by 2 is nothing but Q. Next, till point B. Remaining length Q to B is L by 2, so that I can write R by 2. These are the resistances. Now thermal current. Now thermal current which is entering through it, ITH, thermal current. And here it is leaving, same current, that is thermal currents. Now we would like to calculate a thermal current from A to B, thermal currents. What we have to calculate here, temperature difference between P and Q. We have to calculate what is the temperature between P and Q, that is delta T of P to Q we have to calculate. For this, what we require is a delta, which is like a thermal potential difference also we can call. So thermal currents into thermal resistance. Thermal current into thermal resistance across P and Q. So first, what we have to calculate? Thermal. So to get the desired outputs, first we have to calculate what is thermal currents. Thermal current. Next, thermal resistance across P and Q. Then we can calculate temperature difference between P and Q. So first let me start to calculate the thermal resistance. How to calculate thermal resistance? First, if I proceed here. R, 3R by 2. These two are in a parallel to each other. When these two are in parallel to each other, now resistance across P and Q, resistance across P and Q equal to R1, R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Simply you can substitute here. R1 plus R2, which is nothing but a 3R by 2 into R divided by 3R by 2 plus R, which is nothing but 3R square by 2 divided by, which is a 5R divided by 2. These two will get cancelled. This will get cancelled. Now 3R by phi is nothing but effective resistance between P and Q is 3R by phi. We got now R and P, effective resistance across P and Q. Now what we require is thermal resistance, thermal current we require. Now we can calculate thermal current by taking, let us take this is R by 2, already given R by 2. Now we can simplify this circuit. So here R by 2 is there, first and second the effective resistance is thermal resistance 3R by 5, and here it is R by 5. So R by 5 plus R by 2, sorry. This is nothing but R by 2. R by 2 plus R by 2 is R. So now this is nothing but R and 3R by 5. 3R divided by. These two are in a series. Then A and B. So effective will be written as R of AB equals to effective resistance AB R plus 3R by 2. R plus 3R by 5. Which is nothing but 8R by 5. 8R divided by 5. Hope this is clear. Right. So what we got here. So AB equals to across AB 8R divided by 5. Clear? Now we got a resistance across 3, that is across P and Q we got, and resistance across A and B, thermal resistance. Now we have to calculate thermal current. How to calculate thermal currents? Now thermal current can be calculated here. Thermal currents equals to temperature difference across AB divided by thermal resistance across AB. Now temperature difference across AB is given 120. It's nothing but I'll write 120 divided by resistance across A and B. Just now we calculated, we got resistance across AB equals to 8R by 5. This is clear. So 8R divided by 5. 8R divided by 5. So now we can get 600 by 8R. 600 divided by 8R. This is clear. Now this is the thermal current. Keep it like this. Now thermal currents, we got 600 divided by 8R. Now we have thermal currents as well as thermal resistance across P and Q. Now simply substitute here. That is, we want a temperature difference now. So what we did till now, you can see, we want temperature difference across P and Q. For that, thermal resistance into resistance across P and Q. First, I calculated resistance across P and Q. Then, thermal resistance, thermal current. Thermal current I calculated. Thermal current I got 600 divided by 8R. Now, we can substitute. So, delta T. Thermal current. Got. Now we want a temperature difference across P and Q can be obtained by taking thermal currents multiplied with resistance across PQ. So already we got thermal currents here. 600 divided by 8R multiplied with R PQ. That is a 3R by 5. 3R divided by 5. These two will get cancelled. So we can get 360 divided by 8. This is one, sir. Okay. 120. So 120 into 360. 360 divided by 8, which is nothing but 45 degrees. So delta PQ, which is equals to 45 degrees. Hope this is clear. So which matches with the option 45 degrees is D. Just once you can have a look. Now here we converted in terms of thermal resistances R by 2, R by 2 and 3R by 2. I converted based on thermal resistance formula, where the thermal resistance, it is directly proportional to length. Thermal resistance is directly proportional to length, or delta across P and Q we require to calculate temperature difference across P and Q, which can be obtained by product of thermal current into resistance across PQ. For that purpose, to achieve that purpose, so first we have to calculate thermal currents and then thermal resistance across PQ. So I started by calculating a thermal resistance by using series and parallel combinations. We got thermal resistance across PQ is 3R by 5, RB is nothing but 8R by 5. And then we calculated here thermal currents getting A600 by 8 are thermal currents. Then we substituting in this equation, final result, what we obtained, you can see, which is nothing but 45 degrees. Hope this is clear. This points. A temperature difference. Now here we'll move to JE Main 2014 12th April online, which is based on Newton law of cooling. So hot water cools from 60 to 50 degrees first 10 minutes and 42 degrees in next 10 minutes. The temperature of surroundings we should calculate here. Now we use average form of Newton law of cooling. So average Newton law of cooling, average form. So what is that average form? Which is nothing but delta T, temperature difference by time equal to some constants into average temperature T1 plus T2 divided by 2 minus temperature of surroundings. Right? This will be taken. Here case 1. First, water cools. If I take a water cools from 60 degrees centigrade to 50 degrees centigrade. 50 degree centigrade in first 10 minutes. The time is nothing but 10 minutes. And 42 in next 10 minutes. Here, 42 degrees in next 10 minutes. Right? Then the temperature of surroundings. Temperature of surroundings we require. Let me take case 1 here. Case 1 and this is case 2. In case 1, if I delta T, if I want to write in the above equation form, delta T is 60 minus 50, here T1 and T2 for case 1 divided by 10 minutes equal to some constant K into T1 plus T2, 60 plus 50 divided by 2, directly we can write 55 minus TS, surface temperature, right? Now this can be written as 10 by 10, which is equal to 1 equal to K into 55 minus TS, which is equation number 1 we can write. So 1 is equal to K into 55 minus TS, equation number 1, right? Case 2, we'll go to case 2. In case 2, you can see case 2 here, I'll write case 2, 50 minus 42 divided by time 10 equal to K into 46. Here average, if you take 50 plus 42 divided by 2, we'll get 46 minus surrounding temperature, which I can write 8 divided by 10. 8 divided by 10 equal to K into 46 minus TS. So let me take equation number 2. Divide both the equations. Equation 1 divided by 2. Dividing both the equations. If I divide both the equations, 10 by 8 equals to 55 minus TS divided by 46 minus TS. The cross multiplication. Cross multiply on both sides. We'll get here we can write 5. And it is 4 cross multiplication, 230 minus, that is 5 into 46 minus 5 TS equal to 4 into 4 multiplied 55, 220 minus 4 multiplied TS. Then we can get TS equal to 230 minus 220, which will give surrounding temperature 10 degrees centigrade, which matches with the option B. Hope this is clear. So surrounding temperature. So what is average Newton form of, that is average form of Newton law of cooling is delta T divided by time equal to constant K into T1 plus T2 minus TS. Case 1, if you take, here you can see case 1, 60 to 50 degrees in 10 minutes, 50 to 45 degrees in second case, two cases. I am writing equations, then divided to obtain the answer. Hope this is clear, which is based on Newton's law of cooling. We'll move to the next question. JEE Main 2014 offline, based on a rate of heat flow. First question here. These three rods. There are three rods. Three rods: copper, brass, and steel, welded together in the form of Y shape. So we can. Let me take first rod in a Y shape. They are welded. Second rod, and where it is, third rod. Right. Three rods are there, which are maintained at a temperature 100 degrees centigrade, 0 degrees centigrade. Here it is 0 degrees centigrade. First rod is copper, second rod is brass, and third rod is steel. Fine. Next, area of cross sections of each rod. Area of cross section of each rod is 4 cm square. And end of copper rod is maintained at 100 degrees, already mentioned. Where the ends of brass and steel rods are kept at 0 degrees, which is mentioned there. Next, length of copper, brass, and steel rods are given. Copper, brass, steel, respectively. Let us take L1, 46 centimeters in centimeters, and L2, 13 centimeters, L3, 12 centimeters. We take K1, thermal conductivity is given. 0.92, 0.026, 0.012 CGS units. So 0.92 CGS units. K2 is 0.26 and K3 0.12 CGS units. See. Right. Now let us take here it is L1, L2, L3 in the order. Now heat flow. Here you can see heat flow. This is T1 should be equals to T2 and T3. Entering and T2 and T3. Right? Or sorry, currents I1. It's nothing but due to temperature difference, current I1, I2, and I3, thermal currents. Now at the junction, at this junction, some of the currents entering should be equal to some of the currents leaving, which is nothing but thermal currents. Now, thermal current entering into copper rod should be equal to thermal currents leaving from brass rod plus thermal current leaving from steel rods. That is, some of the currents entering into the junction is equal to some of the currents leaving the junction. To calculate thermal currents, we should calculate thermal resistance. We'll calculate thermal resistance for individual materials. Thermal resistance for copper equal to L1 by K1 into A. L1 is given, 46 length divided by K1 is given 0.92 into area of cross section is 4 centimeters square into 4, which I'll get 100 by 8 centimeter. Okay, next, not CGS units here, something but CGS units. And next, resistance for brass rods equals to L2 divided by K2 into A equals to L2 given as a 13 divided by 0.26. 0.26 into area is 4. Again, we can get after solving 100 by 8 CGS units. Similarly, resistance for steel equal to L1 L3 divided by K3 into area. So L3 can be written as 1 by 0.12. Okay, so here are 12 centimeters, 12 into area of cross section is 4. Which we can get 100 divided by 4 CGS units. Hope this is clear. So thermal resistances for copper, brass, and steel rod we calculated. Next. Next, currents. So current through copper rods, thermal current to copper rod is 100 minus T. T will be taking the junction temperature. Here once you can see, so here it is nothing but temperature T. 100 minus T is the temperature difference across copper. Temperature difference across brass is T minus 0. Temperature across temperature difference across steel is T minus 0. Now we can write 100 minus, that is temperature difference, or temperature difference by thermal resistance of copper. Already we calculated 100 divided by H. Similarly, temperature thermal resistance of brass, T minus 0 divided by thermal resistance, 100 divided by H. Or thermal current for steel equals to T minus 0 by 100 minus 100 divided by 4. Now here we'll be substituting all these values in this equation, that is equation number 1. The above values, if I substitute the above equation, we can obtain here 100 minus T by 100 by 8 should be equal to, here we are taking current through copper should be equal to current through brass plus current through steel. So which is 100 minus T divided by 100 by 8 equal to T minus 0 divided by 100 by 8 plus T minus 0 divided by 100 by 4. Hope this is clear. Right. Now, finally, we can write, if you simplify it, 100 minus T equals to T plus T by 2, which is equal to 100 minus T equal to 3T by 2, or T equal to simplification will get 40 degrees centigrade. So this is called now junction temperature. So we calculated junction temperature. Here you can see once, it's nothing but junction temperature is 40 degrees centigrade. Now we can calculate the heat current through copper rod. So according to the question, rate of flow of heat through copper rod we want. So copper rod rate of flow in a steady state, we can write heat current through copper rod, dq by dt through copper rod should be equal to 100 minus T divided by 100 by 8, which will get 100 minus junction temperature is 40 divided by 100 by 8, 100 divided by 8, which will get 8 into 60 divided by 100, which will get 4.8 calorie per second. This is nothing but dq by dt, the rate of flow of heat through copper rod, which matches with the option here C. Hope this is clear. Once we can check it out, how we calculated. Hope this is clear. Then we'll move to the next question. So JEE Main 2013, 25th April online, which is based on Newton's law of cooling. You can see this question. Mass of 50 grams of water in a closed vessel. So let us take, there is a closed vessel. In this 50 grams of water is present. 50 grams of water in a closed, surrounded at a temperature, takes 2 minutes to cool from 30 degrees to 25 degrees. That means in a time T is equals to 2 minutes to cool its temperature from 30 degrees centigrade to 25 degrees centigrade. This first one. Now one more liquid. The mass of 100 grams of another liquid taken in an identical vessel. This is 100 grams. And identical surroundings take the same time. Taking same time to cool. That means time equal to 2 minutes to cool from 30 degrees to 25 degrees centigrade. Then what is the specific heat of the liquid? Specific heat of liquid we watch. Water equivalent is given. 30 grams and we know that specific heat of water equal to 1. Now using the average form of Newton law of cooling for liquids, we can write a delta T divided by time taken equal to K by M into S plus W into average T1 plus T2 divided by 2 minus surrounding temperature. We'll write the two equations. First case, this one, 50 grams and 30 grams water equivalent. First case, case 1, number 1. So T2 minus T1, 30 minus 25 or delta T we can say in a time interval of 2 minutes already given. K into K divided by specific heat, that is 50 grams into M into S. Specific heat is 1 plus water equivalent is 30. Now T1 plus T2 divided by 2, that is nothing but 30 plus 25 divided by 2. So 30 plus 25 divided by 2 minus surrounding temperatures. Let me take equation number 1. Now second case, case 2, 30 to 25 same, but mass of it is 100 grams. We don't know specific heat of it. Now I can write 30 minus 25 divided by 2 equal to K divided by 100 into O. Specific heat of liquid we don't know, plus 30 into 30 plus 25 divided by 2 minus surrounding temperature, which is nothing but equation number 2. Now divide both the equations, 1 divided by 2. Then we can get 50 plus 30 should be equal to 100 S plus 30. Let's just divide the equation 1 and 2. Or simply we can write 80 equal to 100 S plus 30. Or 100 S is equals to 50. Or we can write 100 S equals to 50. Or S equal to 50 divided by 100. 50 divided by 100, which is equals to 0.5. S is equals to 0.5 kilocalorie per kg. This is the unit for specific heat. Hope this is clear to all. Right? So this is the way that we can calculate specific heat of the given liquid. Just you can go through it. So this is Newton, average form of Newton law in terms of. Is it clear? Hope this is clear to you. Then we'll proceed with the next question, so which is based on Stefan's law. Just so you can try this problem. Next we'll move to JE Main 2012, 12th May online, based on Stefan's law. So heat radiated per unit area in 1 hour by Fernandes, whose temperature is 3000 Kelvin. Sigma is given. Heat radiated per second. Here temperature, when we consider, temperature is very, very high. That is 3000 Kelvin. So we can consider this to be black body. When it is a black body, we can use Stefan's law. Right? Sigma is given to us. So what we have to calculate, heat radiated per unit area. So heat radiated per unit area, directly E equal to sigma into T to the power of 4, a joule per meter square per second, the units for it. Now in 1 hour we want to calculate. So total heat radiated per unit area Q equals to E into T, heat radiated per unit area, or total heat per meter square. Q equals to E into T, T in that specific time. So Q equal to E is sigma into T to the power of 4 into small t. Or Q is equal to sigma. Sigma is 5.7 into 10 to the power of minus 8 into T power 4. T power 4 is 3000 to the power of 4. Into time you take it as 1 hour, T equals to 1 hour, which is of 60 into 60 seconds, which is 3600 seconds. So 3600 seconds, then Q will be approximately substitute 1.66 into 10 to the power of 10 joule per meter square. So joule per meter square. So it's saying that per unit area. So area is unit if I take, which is a nearby option, Q equal to 1.7 into 10 to the power of 10 joules. So which matches with the option A. Answer is A. So direct formula of Stefan's law. Q is equals to E into T. Or sigma equals E equal to sigma into T to the power of 4. So this we are considering as a black body due to its high temperature. Hope this is clear to all. Right? So today, in today class, what we discussed. So first one is based on Stefan's law. Next, Newton law of cooling. Next, rate of heat flow, which is given in 2014. Newton law of cooling, 2014, which is asked on two times. Thermal currents, 2019. Next, energy flux, even 2014 only. Next, 2019, effective thermal conductivity. So these are the topics we discussed in part two. Heat transfer, previous IIT GE questions, Stefan's law, Newton law of cooling, rate of heat flow, thermal currents, energy flux, effective thermal conductivity. Next, in part 3, we will discuss with some of questions deals with the graphs. So that will be the last part of heat transfer previous JEE questions. Hope this is clear to all.